Happy Christmas to you all, wherever you are in the world today. Last year, you may remember that Christmas really felt to many that it had been cancelled. COVID was rife and there were many places closed and travelling was extremely difficult and stressful. People were worried about the safety of their loved ones and for their jobs and finances. Well, today this has been replaced by financial worries due to the high increases in the cost of living, high inflation and interest rates, plus all the difficulties that will ensue as a result of the myriad of strikes over the forthcoming weeks. But today, this morning, let us leave it to God as He is in control. And let's instead accept the promise of the angels given to the shepherds all those years ago, peace on earth and goodwill to all men. May this Christmas bring you peace and joy wherever you are, either surrounded by your family and friends, or even if you're on your own. Glynis will now open our service in prayer and explain what's planned for today. A happy Christmas and enjoy the service.
Come, you to Bethlehem. adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet thee, born this happy
together. Lord God Almighty, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, we are so grateful that you are our Heavenly Father, and we thank you for this special day when we can celebrate the greatest gift you ever sent, when out of your love you gave us a Saviour. We thank you for Jesus, Lord, and we ask that today you will bless our friends, our family, those we love, and our fellowship here at BCF. Father God, please be with those who are going through difficult times, through hardships, and have a special need of you. We ask that you will lay your hand upon them now and meet their needs out of your riches in Jesus. We thank you, Father, for all you provide. And we worship you, Lord. We pray in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our BCF Sunday service, which is also our Christmas Day service this week. We're doing things a little bit differently. We're going to share carols, and we're going to be looking at Christmas cards. This one is my card, and it says, Tidings of joy. The angels brought the shepherds tidings of gladness and joy. And I'm going to read some verses from Isaiah, which relate to a prophecy that was fulfilled when Jesus was born. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace, there will be no end. That prophecy of Isaiah was written more than 700 years before Jesus was born. Why such a long time? God knows the beginning and the end. And this was a perfect time for the prophecy to be fulfilled, as the land was occupied by the Roman army. The Roman Empire was powerful and spread all over the world. It's a message of hope. It was a message of hope to the people at that time who were faithful to God. Reading the Old Testament, we find that there were many wars, and at times the Israelites were taken into captivity. They also turned to idol worship, turning away from God to worship idols. And in time, when they became desperate, they would cry out to God to restore them. God is a God of love, and time after time, he did restore them when they repented. they brought sacrifices week after week. But this is not what God wants. He wants us to worship him from our hearts. It was a perfect time for the prophecy to be fulfilled. And now Eric will carry on with the rest of the story. May I wish you all a very happy Christmas. God bless.
My selected Christmas card to share with you is this one, and it says on the front, if you can't see it, "O little town," and it depicts the town of Bethlehem for the birth of our Lord. The message from the scripture that goes with it is, "But you, Bethlehem, Ephrathah, though you are small among the clans of Judah, out of you will come for me, one who will be ruler over Israel, whose origins are from old, from ancient times. Luke 2 records for us that the Lord Jesus was born in a city called Bethlehem, the city of David. The account tells us that his earthly parents were from somewhere else and had to go there for some purpose, and his earthly mother had to give birth to him there. Why did Mary and Joseph, Jesus' earthly parents, have to go to Bethlehem anyway? Well, as the time drew near for Mary to give birth, the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus called for a census to be held. The Roman Emperor was able to call all the Jews back to their hometowns through the use of a census. Since Joseph was a descendant of David, he had to go back to Bethlehem to comply with such a command from their ruler. This was actually done to fulfill a prophecy in Micah 5 verse 2, the reading I gave at the beginning. God caused this to happen. Since God declared that Christ will come from Bethlehem, God would make it happen. His word will never fail. As it says in Isaiah 55:11, so shall my word that goes forth from my mouth, it shall not return to me void, but it shall accomplish what I please, and it shall prosper in the thing for which I sent it. And so how did God do this? By causing the emperor to decree a census. Proverbs 21:1 tells us that God can do that. The king's heart is in the hand of the Lord, like the rivers of water. He turns it to wherever he wishes.
Thank you.
gathered here today. We've gathered here to pray. Hear our cry. Oh Lord, we need your mercy and we need your grace today. Hear us as we pray.
Christmas to all of our BCF Church on the Mountain Fellowship, wherever you are and however you are celebrating our Saviour's birthday. Glynis mentioned recently that children were cutting into their Christmas cake last year and declaring it as Jesus's birthday cake. Wouldn't it be wonderful if everything the world enjoys at Christmas was related back to the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, his love for us, and the gifts and blessings he bestows on us each and every day, great and small, from the sun's rays and the beauty of the earth to his perfect care and healing and salvation. My card is a picture of the stable, a lowly cattle shed, where the Star of Bethlehem came to rest as Mary and Joseph travelled to Bethlehem and were turned away from the village inn by the innkeeper. Here they took refuge. Joseph and Mary fled as refugees, and all these years later people are still fleeing their countries, desperate for safety and shelter. Our prayers are offered for all in these circumstances. As recorded in the Gospel of Luke, chapter 2, verse 7, "And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn." Swaddling was an age-old practice of wrapping infants in blankets or similar cloths, so that movement of the limbs is tightly restricted. Cosseting the newborn child, ensuring that the babies felt loved, nurtured, warm and secure. Isn't that how Jesus makes us feel when we believe and trust in him? As Sue mentioned a few weeks ago, it's that warm, fuzzy feeling we get that brings peace to our minds and joy to our hearts when we believe in God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. The manger, which was a feeding trough for livestock, is now usually associated with nativity scenes, where Mary and Joseph, forced by necessity to stay in a shed for animals, which some people think it was a cave actually, where they used the manger as a makeshift crib for their baby Jesus, maker, king and saviour of the whole world and humanity. So, when was Jesus actually born? The date of birth of Jesus is not stated in the Gospels or in any historical sources, but most biblical scholars assume a year of birth between 6 and 4 BC. It is thought that the Virgin Mary, expectant of the Son of God, would have given birth to Jesus on the winter solstice. From Rome, the Christ Nativity celebration spread to other Christian churches to the west and east, and soon most Christians were celebrating Christ's birth on December the 25th. Jesus' name in Hebrew was Yeshua, which translates in English as Joshua. Although the precise difference between a name and a title may be open to interpretation, 198 different names and titles of Jesus in the Bible are also listed in Cruden's Concordance, first published in 1737, and continuously in print ever since. Simply put though, his name is Jesus. He loves us all and wants us to know and love him. And through all life's strives and turmoils, he says to us, "Be still and know that I am God." And how wonderful that we have this great opportunity to pray and ask Jesus into our lives any day of the year, and just wait and be still for the good things that will happen in our lives. How blessed we are that this tiny baby was born in that lowly stable for our hope, joy and salvation and ultimate reunion with God in heaven. We continue with our online service with the carol, well, it couldn't be any other really, could it, away in a manger. Have a wonderful Christmas day, everyone, and feel blessed every day. With lots of love. Bye for now. Happy Christmas. Bye.
Happy Christmas to you all. This morning it's my privilege to give one of the readings, and my reading is taken from Luke chapter 2. The shepherds and the angels. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. And they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today in the town of David a Saviour has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." Suddenly a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men on whom his favour rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds had said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as had been told. Amen. Well, you just imagine what it must have been like to be one of those shepherds out in the cold looking after the sheep at night, and suddenly the angel of the Lord appeared to them, and they were terrified, and so would we have been. But they were reassured, and they were told of wonderful things that were happening. The Saviour of the world had been born and was lying in a manger in a stable in Bethlehem. So they pondered on it, and off they went to see this thing. And I would have gone too, wouldn't you? And when they got there, they saw the baby Jesus, and they were amazed all over again. What it must have been like, just think what it must have been like to be one of those shepherds. And they were full of it, and so would we. And we are now today, aren't we, at the things that happened then. And they went off telling everybody about it. And to me, that's what we should be doing this Christmas day. Not about the razzle and tinsel and all the other things that happen. We need to tell people about the wonderful story that is Christmas, the birth of the Saviour of the world. I give thanks to God for that day and for Jesus Christ, my Saviour and yours.
To watch their flocks by night, all seated on the ground, the angel of the Lord came down, and glory shone around. Fear not, said he, for mighty dread had seized their troubled mind. Glad tidings of great joy I bring to you and all mankind. To you in David's town this day is born of David's line, the Savior who is Christ the Lord, and this shall be the sign. The heavenly babe there will find to human view display, all meanly wrapped in swaddling bands and in a manger lay. Thus shining throng of angels praising God on high, who thus addressed this song. All glory be to God on high, and to the earth be peace, goodwill henceforth from heaven. heaven to men begin and never cease.
Well, the card that I've been given to speak about this morning obviously refers to the wise men, sometimes called the Magi. And we hear their story in Matthew chapter 2. Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." Well, I obviously had to wear a star jumper, but you can only see the tip of it, so I'll just show you. Star jumper. Well, we know these men came from the east. We don't know how many of them there were, but we know that they brought three gifts for the new baby born king of the Jews. And so we've always therefore imagined that there were three men, but who knows? What we do know is these men were very determined to meet with and worship Jesus. They had been following the star for no doubt a very great distance. They weren't afraid to approach King Herod when they got as far as Jerusalem, and Herod's chief priests and teachers of the law were able to quote from an Old Testament prophet, Micah, which told them that the Messiah, or the King of the Jews, in answer to their question, would come from Bethlehem. And so they would set off on their way, only 5 miles from Jerusalem to Bethlehem, so they were nearly there. And we read that the star that they'd seen in the east went ahead of them, and it guided them to the place where Jesus was. And we hear that the wise men were overjoyed on finding Jesus and his mother, Mary. They bowed down, they opened their treasures, and they presented him with those gifts of myrrh, frankincense, and gold. So what do we take from this extraordinary element of the story? Well, I think that just as the wise men actively pursued Jesus, surely so should we follow Christ with great determination, letting him be our guiding star. And what gifts shall we bring? And I think the answer lies in the old carol, "In the Bleak Midwinter." What can I bring him, poor as I am? If I were a shepherd, I would bring a lamb. If I were a wise man, I would play my part. But what I can, I give him, give my heart. So let's earnestly follow Jesus this Christmas time. Let's worship him as the wise men did, and let's give our heart and all our gifts to Jesus. And whether you've travelled afar to celebrate Christ's birth this Christmas, as the Magi did, or you've stayed locally, as did the shepherds, I wish you all a very peaceful and happy Christmas, and see you in the new year.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts. We traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with a royal beauty bright. Westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never over us all to reign. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright. Westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Frankincense to offer have I, incense owns a deity nigh. Prayer and praising, all men raising, worship him God most high. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright. West we're leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Myrrh is mine, its bitter perfume, breeze of life, of gathering gloom. Sorrow sighing, bleeding, dying, sealed in the stone cold tomb. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright. Westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Glorious now, behold him arise, King and God in sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, earth to end replies. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright. West we're leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy purpose.